any general advice for what you do for anybody listening?
To do things with passion.
Okay.
Things you love.
Yeah.
Because, excuse me.
That's okay.
Cooking is like love.
Cool, so we're joined here today for another episode of Black Food Tales. As always, I'm your host, Lucimma Pink, and I'm joined today by...
Natalie.
Perfect, and...
Ida.
Ida, okay. So, Natalie, do you mind... Did I pronounce that right?
Natalie. It's perfect.
Thank you. So, do you mind perhaps telling us a bit about your background and how you became who you are today?
My background... I'm Cameroonian, and now also French. commercial and marketing engineer, and I love to cook and I love to write.
Okay. So, what made you cook? Like, what got you into cooking?
Because of my mother, and because I love to eat.
Sure. What's your favorite dish?
Alors là, I have a favorite dish. Periodically.
Sure.
Poisson braisé is a sort of
grilled fish.
Okay.
Like with, barbecuing
with
fish.
Many spices of Cameroon. Yeah. Poulet DG with plantain and many vegetables.
Okay.
Ndolé, gombo, okra sauce.
Okay.
Gombo.
Okay.
So the gombo.
What are the... So for people listening that might not be familiar, what are those type of dishes?
Cameroonian traditional dishes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, cool. Is that what you grew up eating?
I grew up in Cameroon.
Yeah.
And I'm here... I'm in France. Mm-hmm. And, for 20 years.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. And so what do you do now? Do you do...
I'm cooking. I'm giving cooking lessons. I manage workshops.
Okay.
For individuals and companies.
Okay.
And a writer now also.
She's writing poems.
Oh, poems.
Yeah, she loves like doing more. You have the food, but she. Love to translate it in the writing thing.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yes, to show and to share emotions during cooking classes. Yes.
Amazing. Like, later on, could we get an example, maybe?
Alors, you speak so fast, quoi?
Il demande si après ça, tu pourras justement faire lire un de tes poèmes ou...
Okay, d'accord. Yes.
Yeah, okay, no problem.
Perhaps someone else can read it.
Sure.
Yes.
No problem.
I have poems in the book. We can read it, yes.
Okay, amazing. Okay. So I want to go right back to the beginning. So
yes.
You were originally from Cameroon, so you were born there?
In Cameroon, yes.
Yeah, okay. And
in Douala.
So what would perhaps be like as a child growing up, what was a typical perhaps meal you may have eaten as a child that maybe your parents or mum...
A typical plate?
Yeah.
Oui, que tu mangeais quand tu étais petite.
All those I already given names, like ndolé is a sort of, comment on dit, amer. Bitter leaves. Voilà.
Bitter leaves, yeah.
Bitter leaves.
Okay.
With...
cassava leaves?
Arachide.
Peanuts.
With peanuts.
Okay.
It's a very good and very known... you don't know it. dish from Cameroon.
Yeah.
Okra soup also with poisson fumé, fish...
Stockfish.
Stockfish, yes.
Okay. And who would make that for you?
my mother.
Yeah.
My mother and many fish also, fishes also, because we are born in littoral near water.
Okay. Mm. Okay. Yes. Okay. So, what's your favorite fish?
Alors là, my favorite fish, sole. I don't know in English.
Yeah, like the flat.
Yeah. I think it's called sole. Sole as well. Yeah. Okay. And so, as you started to grow up, did your taste in food change at all? Did you like any food from, I guess, other countries at all?
I'm very curious.
Sure.
I love it. To eat, I love everything. Many different flavors of other countries.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So, what was your favorite?
It's difficult, that question. I love French food because they have many sorts of cook products, many sort of meal. When I was in Cameroon, I ate and I love it Greek food. So I love Senegalese food. I love many sort of things.
Okay. So when did you actually arrive in France?
In
1998. How did cooking become a profession?
The love and the passion for cooking, I have them for years, and I decided 3 years ago to transform it into a profession.
Okay.
Yes, and I went to a cooking school to learn about other products of France, to learn about organization.
Yeah.
About kitchen techniques, yes.
Did you find any challenges during that process?
Yes, because I'm very or too creative is a compliment and also a difficulty. I have many ideas, and when you are in a school of cooking, you have a program to respect.
Okay.
And in the beginning, it was very difficult for me to respect the program.
Sure.
And the teacher always said to me, Nathalie, please learn the basics, and after that, go where you want to go. But learn the basics. You are here to learn.
So, would you recommend, now that you did that,
yes,
anybody that wants to follow you, would you recommend they did the same thing?
Alors, even if he's not in the school, to go to a restaurant, to go to see a private chef who has skills, you have to learn something. You're always learning. Cooking is a profession. It's not only the sensorial thing, branché. I want to cook. No, it's a profession. It has rules. Because you can kill somebody by giving him or giving her a meal who is not good.
Yes.
So you have to learn hygiene. I don't know if you
hygiene.
You have to learn so many things.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's not in a school, but you have to go to see those who know And after that, you do what you want to do.
Sure.
But you have to have a foundation.
Do you have any examples of any techniques you may have learned in cooking school or culinary school? Did you call it culinary school? That you may now change to suit your style of cooking?
Alors, a small technique, franchement, very simple, but I love it. It's, voilà. Is they say in French, glacé something.
Okay.
Like frozen something, but is in you cook it, but they say you frozen it because you put sugar, salt, water, and butter. Oh, now I put oil for everybody vegan. Voilà. But the French technique is butter.
Yeah.
I put oil. And you put your vegetable or your, what do they say, féculent?
Steppers.
Inside.
Okay.
And they cooked, and you cover it, and you put comme un trou to let
a hole.
Voilà, a hole.
A roll?
Like okay. So she was talking about a cooking technique.
Yeah.
And at some point you have to make a hole.
Oh, okay.
Yes,
okay.
A hole. Mm-hmm. To let the
steam.
Yes, steam. To steam, voilà, go. And okay. You put not a lot of water.
Okay.
And yeah. That vegetable, what you put that, it cooks with sugar, salt, oil or butter. Really? And after that is brilliant.
Really?
Yes. Yeah. I love that technique.
Okay.
I learned it with carrots.
Okay.
And courgette.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And now I do it with cassava,
yeah.
With yam, with I love it.
Okay. When
and many things like that.
When did you realize you had a talent? Do you have a story about the first
time? I don't even know if I had a talent.
Oh, sure.
Oh my gosh, she has many talents.
I don't know. I know that I'm very creative. I don't know if it is the talent. I love products.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they love me also.
Okay.
Okay. I have the chance to, even if I don't have the recipe, when they say I have this, I want a starter and main dish and dessert, I can do it without knowing the recipe. I love things, I love products. And even when I was young, I always loved products. And I started to write my recipe when I was young.
Okay.
Yes.
Do you remember like one of the first things you made?
First thing.
I think it was okra soup because my mother ate okra soup every day.
Okay.
Okay. And she can do okra soup with everything. Mushroom, orange, everything.
Yeah.
Okra, yes.
So did you learn by her teaching you or you just watched what she did?
I watch and she teach me.
Okay, so a bit of both.
She teach me.
Okay.
Yes.
Do you think cooking is something that can be learnt or is it a talent you're born with?
Is a talent to born with, but if you don't experience it, if you don't learn, if you don't work, it's nothing.
Sure. Okay.
And you perhaps, I don't know if you, comment dire ça, you if you love to cook, like Ida, is every day with the chef.
Yes.
Sometimes you the love for the cook comes because you are with passionate person. And we can you can learn also. For me, you can learn if you have a passion and passion, you can learn. Even talent will come if you want to learn. If you say I have talent and you don't want to comment dire. If you have talent, you have to show it, you have to improve it.
So practice.
To practice, yes.
Okay. Is there any dishes you don't like to make?
But dishes I don't even know.
Okay. Sure. Okay. So after you finished your school,
yes.
What was the next step? What happened after that?
Alors, before my school, I have a blog.
Okay.
I have a blog before going to school.
Okay.
After school, I create a small company, Envolée Gourmande.
Yeah.
To give cooking lessons, to do workshop for companies and individuals, to be comment dire ça, culinary advisor, in France is consultant.
Yes.
If you have you have your restaurant and you want to change the menu, or if you want to learn how to do baking with African flowers, because I do that a lot with cassava, yam, maize, voilà. Flour to do baking.
Oh, really?
I love doing that.
Okay.
I can help you if you pay me.
Sure. You have to earn a living, right? Okay. Okay. So, what made you, just to go backwards?
Yes.
What made you start the blog? What was on your blog?
Yes. I started the blog because of. In fact, they say grassa because of, I don't know, because of his negative, but it was a very good experience. It's my daughter, Candice, who said, make a blog. You love to write, you love to cook, and you cook for 10, 20 persons,
sure.
But we just four in the house. I cook every time, every day. And when I receive, c'est recevoir des gens, people, every time they ask me, where is the receipt? Where do you see that receipt? I say, it's my recipe.
Okay.
And I do the blog to share
those
recipes. Yes.
When you make food, did you always write down the recipes or do you just remember everything?
I write the recipe if I want that food to go to the blog.
Oh, okay.
Because
okay.
To the blog, you have to explain the quantities, the what you do. And sometimes no, because sometimes I don't even know what I want to do. I have products or I open my refrigerator.
Yes, your fridge, yeah.
To a fridge,
yeah.
To see what I have,
yeah.
And I do a recipe.
Okay, amazing.
Yes. When I say to write, it's
yes.
Not only write a recipe, it's write the emotion I have
yeah.
To cook.
Okay, 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 okay.
It's two different things.
Sure.
Yes.
Do you think there has been a rise in popularity of food from Cameroon? Do you think people are taking more notice? They're more interested now?
They have to.
They have to? Okay.
They have to, yes. Yesterday, I published a photo.
Okay.
In Instagram.
The one with the plantain?
Yes.
Yes, I swear.
comment ça s'appelle, poulet DG, okay. Manager, general manager, chicken.
Okay.
Is a dish from Cameroon, very good, very colorful, and I write that Cameroonian food is the one of the most rich and various food in the world, and the world have to know that.
Sure. Okay.
And I work in it with many other persons.
Okay. Do you feel there's a difference in how people respond to food in France versus the UK?
In UK, I came on Thursday.
Oh, okay. It's first time?
No, I was here 15 years ago.
Oh, wow.
With my husband, but okay. It was a romantic trip.
Okay.
And now I see chef, I see comment appelle ça, person who has company in food is another challenge. Donc I don't know the response. I can't compare now.
Sure. Okay.
Yes.
What is your dream for London? Is it more like private chef and the training and the company events, that kind of thing?
I love to dream.
Okay.
Because if I say it's private chef, it's cooking a son, perhaps some other big opportunities are there. I don't know. Events, I don't know.
Okay.
Open-minded.
Sure.
I don't know.
Okay.
And I also want to share and to sell and to share and to speak about my book.
Yeah, tell us. I'm gonna take some pictures and then I'll put that up as well. I'll put some links in the podcast as well. Tell us a bit about your book.
I write the book for many reasons. I explain in the book. We have, when I say we have, is Afro and Caribbeans. We have oral heritage.
Yeah.
We don't have many books to speak about our products, our meals, our cultural food. I decided to write because the book is not like the blog.
Okay.
You can buy the book to offer it to somebody.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
My mother-in-law
mm-hmm.
has buy the book
mm-hmm.
to give it to someone or mm-hmm. to read it,
mm-hmm.
but she will not go to my blog to read.
Okay.
It's a precious object.
Sure.
Even if now everybody is connected, I'm sure that the book has its place.
Was it a challenge creating the book?
Yes, a big challenge because in the cooking book, I think a cooking book is more difficult. I don't want to say that. It's very difficult because you have a recipe.
Yeah.
You have photo.
Yeah.
Photos is not simple.
Sure.
When you put, you say you have 5 ingredients, for example, when you write, sometimes you forget 1 or 2.
Okay.
It's not simple.
Yeah, I'm sure it can happen very easily.
And after that, you have to pay because I'm auto-editor, I don't know.
Self-publish?
Yes,
okay.
Self-publish.
Yeah.
You have to find money.
Yeah. Yeah.
To have a graphist, an imprimeur is what print to print your your book.
Yeah.
You have so many things to do.
So do you have any advice for any cooks or chefs that are listening? I want to follow in your footsteps.
About the work in general or the book?
So the book, and then I'll come back to the work in general.
Okay. It's not easy, but try to write down your recipe.
Okay. Okay.
If it's a traditional recipe, you will have a public, because many people don't know how to do their traditional meals. If it's a creative recipe,
yeah,
write them, because sometimes you forget what you do yesterday, the day before.
Sure.
Voilà. If you don't know how to take photos, you have so many great photographs. You have to make beautiful photos, because you don't know if you will have a book. You have to do like you will have a book.
So as you go along, keep taking nice pictures, just in case.
Like nice pictures. The first step is your recipe.
Okay.
You have to write it.
Yes. Yeah.
Because you do something today, and tomorrow you don't even know what you do.
Okay.
We have to write.
Yeah.
We have to go to the elders to ask questions, to write down the recipe. So many things are, I don't know, s'envoler, go away.
Sure.
Yes.
Okay. Do you think recipes should stay traditional, or should we mix it with European or other dishes to introduce new people?
Alors, comment dire ça? Ndolé is a traditional Douala and Sawa dish.
Okay.
I don't change for me. I don't change the recipe of Ndolé. I presented it differently. I don't change it. If I want to do creative things, for me, I take those leaves and do another thing. But it's not Ndolé. Ndolé is a name. It's like comment on dit ça? A brand.
Okay.
For me.
Yes. Yeah.
Because now everybody wants to mix everything. When I went to a cooking school, I learned French recipe.
Yes.
They have French recipe in a book. If you say, I do a blanquette de veau, I don't know, blanquette de veau. It's a blanquette de veau. If you want to change it, you will say, blanquette de veau on my own.
Okay.
But
okay,
you
okay.
have the base of the recipe.
Yes.
My professor always said, know the basics, and after that, do what you want to do.
Mm.
But many people now don't know the basics. Seems like they are revolutionary, I don't know, in the food.
Yeah.
It's good to know the basics and change the basics if you want, but if they ask you traditional meal, you will be able to do that traditional meal, is my opinion.
Sure. It's good to hear.
I'm very creative, but creativity is here, tradition is here, and I navigate
between. Okay.
But I will not take my ndolé, to put orange, to put mango, and I say, this is ndolé.
Okay.
No, it's a sort of ndolé if I want, even change the name.
Okay.
But ndolé is ndolé. Because we will, perdre, lose all the tradition because we want to do the modern type of thing. Mm. You can do the modern type of thing, but you have to know the basic.
Mm.
Is what the Asian, the mm-hmm. European or in France, they mm. have books mm-hmm. with traditional meals.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's true.
We
it's
have true. To do traditional meals, yes. And I say, and you say, c'est pas moi, jollof with mushroom and mint. I don't know what you do, but do you know to do the white jollof?
Mm-hmm.
Oui ou non? Voilà.
So if I understand, mm-hmm. learn the basics.
Yes.
And if you change it,
yes.
give it a new name, because it's not the same.
It's not the same.
Okay.
It's not the same. All say is a sort of jollof on my own.
Oh, okay, okay.
With
okay, okay.
this creative touch.
Yeah.
But don't go to someone who didn't know jollof yeah. at all and say the jollof is with the mango.
Okay.
You understand what they
so
say?
It's a bit about the mm. the restaurant or the chef being very honest about what they're giving.
Oh la la. The white word is honest.
Okay. Okay, sure.
Honest, yeah. Respect the product, respect the client and the people. Voilà.
Yes, okay.
So sometimes to comment on dit ça en français? I will not have. Je vais pas me faire beaucoup d'amis, je sais pas comment on dit.
I'm not going to make the
name. Yes, sometimes someone didn't know to cook. And mix everything to do a modern type of thing, but if you they don't know to cook, because sometimes cooking is very simple, not the addition of many things. No.
So on while we're talking about bad cooking, when someone makes a bad dish, do you think it's better to tell them it's bad? Or should we help their self-esteem as they're learning?
Alors, bad dish, the problem is that maintenant, bad dish is what? You will say is my creation.
Yeah, true. Because everybody
bad
has...
dish is what? It's like a poem. If yeah. you say my poem is not good, I don't know. It's subjective.
True.
But if you do a traditional meal, they can say it's not good. Because yeah, we have étalon de modèle.
Yes. Okay. I understand. Okay. So just to rewind just a little
yes.
bit. We were touching on advice. So you gave some advice in creating a book.
Yes.
I just wondered if you had any general advice for what you do for anybody listening.
To do things with passion.
Okay.
Things you love.
Yeah.
Because, excuse me.
That's okay.
Cooking is like love. If you marry somebody you don't love.
Yeah.
After one hour of... comment dit when you are not with angry,
yes.
I don't know, you will not support that person.
Yeah,
you
not
you have to do what you love.
Yes.
Because when you love something, you are passionate.
Mm. sure.
Yes.
Sure. Yeah.
Donc do what you love. Not now, African gastronomies are in the spotlight. I will do it.
Mm-hmm.
Do it if you love it.
Do you think it's okay for somebody who's learning, they're amateur, is it okay for them to cook or learn in restaurants that they don't like just so they learn the trade, they learn the craft before they start their own?
If I understand, somebody who learned something he don't like,
yes,
just to finish his stage,
so they learn more about cooking,
yes,
and then they can do their own. Is that okay, you think?
that person can try to see if he can have another restaurant he like with a chef or with products he like. There are so many restaurants you can change if you are not comment dire, if you are not comfortable with that that restaurant. Because if you are not comfortable at all, it can comment dire, you can even not want to open your own restaurant because of the you have to change. You have to change.
Okay. I wanna ask you some quick fire questions.
Yes.
Yeah. What celebrity would you like to cook dinner for?
Hey, Messiah. What celebrity?
Yes.
Celebrity in music, sport, in
anything. It could be Tour de France. It could be anything.
Oh là là là. Alors là. Il me pose une colle. Perhaps English celebrity.
Yeah, sure. English celebrity.
Don't laugh. Huh?
No, it's fine. Okay.
Prince Charles.
Prince Charles, yeah? Okay.
Why? Because he likes organic products.
Okay.
Yes.
And what would you make Prince Charles?
Where?
What would you make? What would you cook?
Ah, what? I read somewhere that he has a garden.
Okay.
With organic vegetables. Donc, cook his vegetables with spice of Cameroon.
Nice. Yes. any Pacific dish at all?
Alors, it depends on what he has, like vegetable.
Sure, okay.
And
okay.
I will cook it with spices. We have a pepper, poivre de penja.
Yeah.
Who is very, very good. Some chef, c'est pas chef étoilé, je sais pas comment on dit ça.
Well-known chef, okay.
Yes,
yeah.
Says that now is the best pepper in the world.
Okay.
We have many spices like that. I want to do a marriage of our spices with his vegetable, organic vegetable.
What's your best midnight snack?
Alors, best midnight snack. Tac. It's haricot beans or red beans.
Red beans, okay.
With bread with sardine. C'est pas comment on dit.
Okay.
Sardine.
Sardine. Yeah.
Sardine à l'huile. Sardine with oil.
Oil, yeah, okay.
And pia s'appelle comment? L'avocat, avocado.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
We eat like that in Cameroon.
Nice.
And pili piment. Pepper.
Oh, okay.
Pili chili. Ouais.
Okay, chili. Nice. is there a chef whose cooking you like?
So many chefs.
Just one.
Oh la la. Oh la 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 la. So many chefs. Just one. Just one. It's difficult.
Any
difficult because I love some African chef.
Okay.
And some French chef.
Okay. So one African chef. Any African chef.
I'm not French chef. One African chef. So many chefs. Abela Ola, Abegan. A young Gabonese chef en tout.
And
chef en tout.
What summer ingredient are you excited about cooking with?
Spices of Cameroon.
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay. And what makes good... Oh, wait. What, is there any special spice?
Yes. That pepper.
The same.
Or, white or dark. Noir, black.
Voilà. Okay.
I have also abra lai. Is that? Is garlic tree.
Okay.
It smells like a garlic. You can smell
it?
Yes. But it's a tree.
It's a tree?
Yes.
Okay.
Garlic tree.
So cool.
You have so many spices.
So I'm just smelling this now. It's for everybody listening. Ooh. Smells really nice.
Rondelle, bobimbi, olombe, so many names.
I don't even know how to describe it, but that
is magic.
There's a lot in there, but it's very, very nice. Okay, cool. For everybody on YouTube, that's it. I'll maybe take a picture and put it up. Thank you.
I had to. Je dois regarder là-bas. Non. La caméra là. Non, la placer. Ok.
Define good food. What is good food?
Food you do with love.
What is a dish everybody needs to try before they die?
What the food everybody needs to try before they die? Alors, definitely one of Cameroonian food.
Why not?
Alors, I hesitated between grilled fish with those species. Oh, beignet, c'est quoi?
Puff-puff.
Bon, j'en appelle ça puff-puff, oui.
Puff-puff, okay.
With red beans.
With red beans,
yes.
Yeah. Yes. Nice. So, I want to thank you for being an amazing guest today. For anybody listening, how can we find you on your Instagram, your website? How can we find you?
Alors, in Instagram and Facebook and Twitter, Envolée Gourmande, c'est pour ça que je voulais donner ma carte, parce que c'est Envolée Gourmande.
Ok.
Envolée Gourmande.
Envolée Gourmande. I think I said it. Ok.
Envolée Gourmande.
Envolée Gourmande. Yeah.
In English, c'est quoi? Envoler, c'est to fly.
Okay.
With testiness, I don't know.
Okay.
Testy fly, je vois. Envoler gourmande.
Okay.
Is the name. Envoler gourmande. And in the my website is envolergourmande.com and envolergourmande.fr. Okay. Envoler gourmande.
I'll make sure I link up to this in the show notes
and
in the description and everything like that. Just before we finish, I do remember Ida promised to read us a poem.
In the book, we have two sorts of poems.
Okay.
A poem about food.
Okay.
And a poem about my mother who passed away.
I'm sorry.
Yes.
Okay.
She has to quelque chose.
Is this one about?
La vie est belle. De la vie est belle, comment dire?
Life is beautiful.
Life is beautiful. Yes.
Okay, amazing. Take it away.
La vie est belle. Je sais, vivre n'est pas non plus ignorer l'affliction, le manque d'elle, le tourment qui me brûle jusqu'à la déraison. Alors, lorsque les souvenirs se font chaos, quand le monceau de douleur pèse sous mon cœur, en lambeaux, je m'enveloppe dans son long manteau et l'odeur fugace de son indélébile parfum, le doux écho de son rire lointain me disent soudain qu'en dépit du chagrin, la vie est belle.
Thank you so much. So yes, I want to thank you for being an amazing guest on our podcast today.
Thank you.
And yeah, thank you guys for watching and thank everybody for listening. See you guys in the next episode. Once again, I want to thank you so much for listening to today's episode. As always, I've put together some show notes for you. You can find those over at blackfoodclub.com/012. That's blackfoodclub.com/012. I'll see you guys in the next episode. And as always, with the Black Food Club, you're invited. Almost thought we finish, but we actually got some bonus content for you guys. We're going to talk a little bit about the book. You were saying that you won an award or some kind of prize for your book.
Yes, in May, this month, the book won the prize of La Foire de Paris. Is an exhibition. Well, international. It's la vérité, c'est ça? Yes. And the book won the prize of gastronomy book. The book was chosen by Organisation Mondiale de Gastronomie, World Organization.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. The book, is it available in English as well?
Yeah. Not yet.
Okay.
But you can translate like you do.
Yes.
You can explain to translate. Huh?
Yeah, so everybody listening or watching, so just before we started recording, I had a sneak peek inside the book.
Yeah, voilà.
And I use the app Google Translate, and it's got this thing where you literally just hold up your camera and it will translate the whole page for you. So yeah, there you have it. Amazing. And this book, is that available through your website?
Yes.
Okay.
But you have to send an email.
Okay.
Because every country has, every region has the price for the transport.
Transportation, shipping?
Yes, shipping.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
The book has a price, but I have to have the transport.
Understand.
Yes.
Understood.
And I can care again to do a dedicace. I don't know.
You can.
The dedicace when you write.
Oh, you sign. Sign autograph.
Yes.
Okay, amazing.
Okay.
Yeah, amazing. Yes. So yeah, I want to thank you again for sharing, and yeah, please, people,
thank
support excellence whenever you get a chance. So see you guys in the next episode.